Okay, shalom to the elect of the nation of Israel, the elect of Yahweh Shai. All praises and glory is due to Yahweh Bashem Yahshai, Bashem Rakakwadash, for giving us this knowledge, this truth, this understanding, especially in the times we're living in, which indeed is a blessing, knowing this truth. Anyway, you see here on screen, this is from News Nation. The title of the article says, Summer blackouts could hit these U.S. states, regulators warn. And as you see here, it says 2 days ago, this article was put out. Now, what inspired me to go into this topic was a video that Elder Apostle did about a day ago, entitled Blackouts This Summer. So bottom line is, things are gonna get pretty damn dark around here very soon. All right, the dark days of summer. You heard the saying, the dog days of summer. Well, let's replace it with, the dark days of summer is coming very soon. And you know, it could trigger chaos. You know, when the power goes out, it could trigger chaos, and especially at night. Okay, you know the old song by the rap group Houdini, "The freaks come out at night," right? So the freaks are really going to come out at night if you have a total blackout, okay? And that's all part of Jacob's trouble that the scriptures speak about in the 30th chapter of Jeremiah, around the 7th verse. That's all part of Jacob's trouble. So again, summer blackouts could hit these United States, regulators warn. So I'm going to read some of this article here, and as usual, I'm going to follow it up with scriptures as the Holy Spirit will allow me to say. So let's just jump into it. It says, blackouts could plague a number of states. So that's a plague. When you have a blackout, that means there's no power. That means unless you have a lamp or candles or a generator, right? You'll pretty much be in the dark, right? But not only that, not just being in the dark. I mean, you can't really enjoy your entertainment because there's no power, unless, like I said, you have a generator or some other means of getting power. And let's not forget, for those that are not fortunate to have a generator or no other means of power, they're totally at the mercy of the state to supply their electric. How about the refrigerators? The food that needs to stay cold so it doesn't go bad is going to go bad. Let's say you have 3 days of blackouts back to back. Come on, man. Pretty much the food in the refrigerator is going to start going bad, and which means you'll have to throw the food out. Okay? Think about that. I mean, you have a lot of worst case scenarios during a blackout. It's not a good thing. Okay, so blackouts could plague a number of states in the U.S. this summer, regulators warn, as a combination of drought, heat, and, you know, maybe, just maybe, Yahweh Bashem Yahshua will make this a real hot summer, okay? As a combination of drought, heat, potential cyber attacks. Okay, so and you know, you see cyber attacks, you know that's created. You know that's created by the insiders, the wicked elite, okay, to drum up chaos so that they can bring in the order. You know, it goes back to the old motto of the New World Order, which is ordo ab chao, order through chaos. That's why they're going to do it. A lot of people will, you know, they'll say, who are not really conspiracy minded. And indeed, there's always a conspiracy. Okay, the word conspiracy literally means to breathe together. So wherever there's two or three, there's your conspiracy. There are people behind the scenes that are breathing together, meaning discussing together, right? Plans on how to totally take over the people. Okay, this goes back to Psalm, the 64th chapter. The Bible calls it the secret council of the wicked elite. That's their secret council. So one of the things on the agenda is blackouts. Absolutely. Okay. Blackouts is part of the agenda of chaos that the wicked elite want to bring in order to bring control or order. Matter of fact, there was a show back in the 60s. The name of the show was Get Smart. Okay, the central character in the show was Maxwell Smart. And I believe his name was, I forgot, I think his first name, the actor, was Don Adams. Yeah, Don Adams was the actor who played Maxwell Smart from the show Get Smart. Now, if you've ever watched the show, you know that there was two groups opposing each other. You had control and you had chaos. Check that out, man. You had control. You know, the 60s, one thing about the 60s, a lot of those shows were totally Illuminati, man, illuministic. Bewitched came about in the 60s. The Munsters came about in the 60s. The Addams Family, where they were making mockery. Pretty much the Addams Family was the wicked elite making mockery of the Israelites, because we came out of Adam. We're the chosen line of Adam. But maybe I'll do a video on that some other time. But we're focusing on Get Smart. So this is how you get smart. You get smart by having chaos, and then justified by the chaos, you bring in control. That's how you get smart. Okay, again, go back to the show. You had the two groups, control and chaos. Okay, so that's how you get smart. All right, and that's what the top wicked elite want. They want chaos in order to bring control, and a blackout could do it. A blackout is part of the chaos program. Okay, so you better believe it's going to happen this summer. Absolutely. And it's probably going to happen around the hottest time of the year, which is 2 months, July and August. Oh, that's another thing too. A lot of people rely on their AC, their air conditioning unit, right? So if you have a blackout, guess what? The air conditioning unit does not work. So can you imagine, like, those people in the projects, okay, like in Brooklyn? I know for a fact, right? Because I remember when I used to live in Brooklyn in the late 80s to early 90s. Man, if it was 100 degrees in the suburbs, you better believe in places like Flatbush, where it's all concrete, you barely see any trees, and you know, rows and rows of projects and houses and shit, you better believe it was about 120, because the heat was bouncing off the concrete and radiating up. Okay? Yeah. So you got a lot of these so-called old people, you know, they die from heat stroke. And if you factor in a blackout, your AC ain't working, a lot of these old people are going to die from heat stroke. So, man, we just got to wait and see how it's going to turn out. But it's not going to be anything good. That's for sure. Anyway, let's keep reading. It says potential cyber attacks. I keep saying cyber attacks. Cyber attacks. Geopolitical conflicts. Whatever the hell that is. Okay, and supply chain problems could disrupt the power supply, according to a grim, look at the word grim there. All right, here we go. Here's the definition. Grim, forbidden or uninviting. Yeah, I would say a blackout is uninviting. Who the hell wants that? According to a grim new report from the North American Electric Reliability Corporation, NERC, the regulatory body found that large swaths of the U.S. and parts of Canada are at an elevated or high risk of energy shortfalls during the summer's hottest months. And you better believe that's going to be staged. That's going to be planned, okay? The Midwest is at especially high risk due to the retirement of older plants, which has caused a 2.3% decrease in capacity from last summer, as well as increased demand, according to NERC. In the Southwest, plummeting river levels may cripple hydropower production, the group warned. And in Texas, you know how hot it gets in Texas, okay? Drought-related heat events could cause extreme energy demand. All right? And here they have a map of the highest risk, and it seems to be in the Midwest, and the elevated risk. Now, when I took a look at that article, it reminded me of in the scriptures where ancient Egypt had a blackout. Okay, now you know that America is the modern day Egypt, because America carries the symbols of ancient Egypt. Now I always bring out this example. You have something called the Washington Monument, right? The Washington Monument is really an Egyptian obelisk. Now the word monument means to remember. You erect a monument so you can remember an event, right? So the pyramids are supposed to remind us, the pyramids and the obelisks, I'm really focusing on the obelisks or the obelisks, they're supposed to remind us of Egypt. And that's what is called the so-called Washington Monument is really an Egyptian obelisk or obelisks. Okay? So this is part, you know, part of the proof of America being the new Egypt, as it were. Okay? So in ancient Egypt, you had blackouts. Okay, here's an example from the book of Exodus, the 10th chapter. And that was one of the plagues. Now, remember in the article, let's get back to the article. It calls the blackout what? A plague. Right? Isn't that what it said? Well, let's go back and read it. Blackouts could plague a number of states in the U.S. Now, remember, during the time of Moses and Pharaoh, there were many plagues brought upon Egypt before the Heavenly Father finally took down Pharaoh and his army, thereby crippling ancient Egypt. Because after Pharaoh and his army was taken down, Egypt never rose to the prominence that it once had. And then the Lord prepared an exodus of his people out of Egypt, which the word exodus means to go out. All right, to go out. So the Lord, the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, through his son Yahweh Shai, because Yahweh Shai was back there, he was the angel of death, the Heavenly Father Yahweh, through Yahweh Shai, brought an exodus for his people, the Israelites, and we went back to the land of Canaan, which later would be known as the land of Israel, okay? But before that happened, the Heavenly Father Yahweh brought a series of plagues on ancient Egypt. So it's the same thing now. A series of plagues are about to come on modern-day Egypt, right? Which is America today. Modern-day Egypt is America. You see, in the Bible, America goes under many different names. You're not going to see the name America in the Bible. But America goes under many different names. Egypt, Babylon, or Babylon the Great, Nineveh, okay? So this is the book of Exodus, the 10th chapter. It says this, "And the Lord said unto Moses, stretch out thine hand toward heaven, that they may know." Now, this was a plague that the Lord brought upon upon ancient Egypt. The Lord told Moses that he would bring plagues upon ancient Egypt until the Pharaoh let his people go. Okay? Let me just get, before I go to the verse I was going to read, let me just see if I find anything before that that would be edifying. Because it was all about Pharaoh finally letting the Lord's people go, which are the Israelites. And the scriptures clearly tells you that the Heavenly Father Yahweh kept hardening the heart of Pharaoh. That's why he wouldn't let him go. And the reason why the Heavenly Father kept hardening Pharaoh's heart, meaning his mind, to let his people go, is because the Heavenly Father wanted to use Pharaoh to show his power. Okay? That's why. That's why the Heavenly Father, finally the Heavenly Father allowed Pharaoh to let the people go after the last plague, which was the plague of the firstborn in Egypt dying, all right? The firstborn not only of the soldiers and of the men in Egypt, the Egyptians, but of their cattle too, of their animals. When you go back and read the account. So after that, the so-called Egyptians were so shook that they, you know, beginning with the Pharaoh, they decided to, the decision was made to let these Israelites go. But then the Lord hardened Pharaoh's heart one more time, and Pharaoh decided to pursue the Israelites, even to the Gulf of Suez, which is the northern part of the Red Sea. And what happened there? The Heavenly Father split open the Gulf of Suez and allowed the Israelites to go through, and at the same time blocked the Egyptians, meaning Pharaoh and his army. And when the Israelites made it to the other side, the Heavenly Father took away that block and at the same time closed the waters upon Pharaoh and his army, and every last one of them drowned. So the Heavenly Father showed his mighty power in the destruction of Pharaoh. Okay? And he's getting ready to do it again. Esau right now is the modern day Pharaoh, and America is the modern day Egypt. Okay? As it is written, there's no new thing under the sun. Remember that. Anyway, Exodus 10. So we're just going to go to the point. Excuse me. It is right here. Exodus 10. I was just looking at the previous verses to see if there was something I could read. Exodus 10 and 20. But the Lord hardened Pharaoh's heart so that he would not let the children of Israel go. And the Lord said unto Moses, stretch out thine hand toward heaven, that there may be darkness over the land of Egypt, as in a blackout, even darkness which may be felt. So that's some powerful darkness, man. And Moses stretched forth his hand toward heaven, and there was a thick darkness in all the land of Egypt 3 days. So, oh man, check this out. What if a 3-day blackout period came to most of the states in America, huh? Would that not trigger? And you know, the wicked elite will do that just to see the reaction of the people. Remember in the book of Psalm 64, right? You think the wicked elite wouldn't allow three days of darkness to plague the land, plague the states, the different states? Come on, man. I'm pretty sure that's on the agenda of the wicked elite. Let me say it that way. This is Psalm 64. And now Psalm 64 is talking about the thinking of the wicked elite of Esau, which really they get their power from the Heavenly Father Yahweh. They get their orders from the Heavenly Father Yahweh. They get their marching orders from the Heavenly Father Yahweh. Remember, the Heavenly Father Yahweh controls everything. He controls good as well as bad. Okay? That's one thing you got to learn about the Heavenly Father Yahweh, right? So in Psalm 64, it speaks about what? The secret counsel of the wicked. Psalm 64 and 2, hide me from the secret counsel of the wicked, from the insurrection of the workers of iniquity, who whet their tongue like a sword and bend their bows to shoot their arrows, even bitter words. And the wicked elite starts with the top banking families, and you better believe they got their priesthood, okay? And they're trying to bring a so-called New World Order. It's on the back of the dollar bill with the pyramid and the all-seeing eye. And one of the ways they want to bring that so-called New World Order is to scare people into accepting it through the chaos they're going to bring. Hence the motto, Auto Ab Chaos. Remember the show, Get Smart? That's how you get smart. You have chaos and you have control. A blackout is a controlled opposition. It's controlled. It can be controlled. It can be directed, okay? Crafted, if you will. So Psalm 64 and 3, who wet their tongue like a sword and bend their bows, who wet their tongue like a sword, that means their legislation. It's called draconian legislation. See, they'll create a chaos and the people will be scared. So now here they come with the draconian legislation that forces people. And in most cases, the draconian legislation is created to force people to give up their rights, to give up their so-called freedom. Okay? The wicked elite is encroaching slowly but surely on the so-called freedoms of the people until the people have no freedom left. That's what they want. They're totally controlled. Okay? So this is why we're praying to Yahweh Bashim Yahshua, as the scripture have said, to bring Esau down, to bring him down. Okay? Who wet their tongue like a sword and bend their bows to shoot their arrows, even bitter words, draconian legislation, that they may shoot in secret at the perfect. We're the perfect, us Israelites. Suddenly do they shoot at him and fear not. Now here's the point. They encourage themselves in an evil matter. So they actually have think tanks. They sit down and they discuss, how can we totally control these people? How can we make these people total slaves? Oh, we're going to scare the shit out of them. Then if they're scared enough, they'll throw their hands up in the air and demand for a solution. And that's where we come in with the solution, which is more and more legislation, more and more government control, more and more... what's the word I'm looking for? When you pry into someone's business, there's a word for it. Anyway, the word escapes me, but hopefully it'll come to me. They encourage themselves in an evil matter. They commune of laying snares privately. What's a snare? Trap. So yes, they can trap you into totally giving up your rights. All they got to do is create a huge example of chaos, and there you are. You not knowing that the thing is controlled, it's been contrived. You not knowing that, you throw up your hands in the air and you demand for a solution from the same government, which the word government means control, mind control, from the same government who created it, huh? Here you are demanding a solution from the same government who created it. You see? So that's a snare, man. They encourage themselves in an evil matter. They commune of laying snares privately. They say, who shall see them? Yeah, because they hide behind their secret societies. They hide behind their secret language. And unless you're in the know, right? Unless you're in the know, then you don't know. Okay? Then we go to the sixth verse. It says, they search out iniquities. So could they create a total three-day, 72-hour blackout? Total blackout? No power, absolutely? Come on, you tell me. And they're going to do it. Okay? They search out iniquities, they accomplish a diligent search, both the inward thought of every one of them and the heart is deep. Yeah, thoughts of wickedness, thoughts of destruction. Because remember, Esau's blessing is destruction. Esau's blessing is the sword. Okay, let's never forget that. All right? So, pretty much, let's get back to Exodus and we'll wrap this video up. So there's your example of blackness, darkness over Egypt. Okay? Exodus 10 and 21, and the Lord said unto Moses, stretch out thine hand toward heaven, that there may be darkness over the land of Egypt, even darkness which may be felt. And Moses stretched forth his hand toward heaven, and there was a thick darkness in all the land of Egypt 3 days. They saw not one another, neither rose any from his place for 3 days, but all the children of Israel had light in their dwellings. Now, of course, during the day, you're going to have light, all right? But, you know, that's the difference. But in Egypt, there was actual darkness for 3 days. Now, could the Lord do something like that here in America? It's quite possible. Where, I mean, it's just totally, completely dark. The Lord could do that. It's not beyond him to do it. We just have to wait and see. But we do know, according to this article, this we know, we're sticking to the facts here, this we know, that blackouts is a very real possibility for this summer, especially at night. That's when the blackouts are really gonna, that's when they're really gonna resonate at night. Okay? So once again, you know, another example of Jacob's trouble, the blackouts, okay? As a matter of fact, I think that's what I'll call this video. So I'll end it there. Hopefully you brothers and you sisters were edified. You know, our job is to warn you and keep you abreast of what's going on and what to expect. You know, remember, as it is written, this is not our rest. What does it say in Micah 2 and 10? This is not our rest. This place is polluted. It shall destroy you. So we're not going to rest in this place. You know, we're not going to rest in this place. This is not our rest. We're going to rest in the kingdom. As it is written again, there remaineth a rest for the people of the Heavenly Father, but not here. It's going to be in the kingdom, man, in our land, the land of Israel, after this job is done, after this work is done. All right, that being said, on to the next one.